those buying is not owning, and those using the world is not using it fully. For the world in its present form is passing away. The word of the Lord.
Side to the other, because we hear it as we just did, a reading from the Holy Gospel. We are called to live and proclaim gospel action, to repent and believe. And we see this prefigured in the first reading from the prophet Jonah. This prophet Jonah was really not only a prophet for those of you that know the story. Eventually, he goes about what God calls him to do, and the people turn from their evil way. And then we hear God himself turn from his way. He repented as well. In the second reading, St. Paul exhorts us to turn away from the reality of the world in order to turn to the reality of God. And this is really what repentance is. It's a turning away from sin, turning away from distraction, and turning to our God. Jonah, St. Paul, and Jesus himself all call for repentance. But this is not limited to a time and place in history. John made clear the urgency that Jonah was to proclaim his message to the people of Nineveh. St. Paul, his message is also urgent. His first words were, "His time is running out. This world is passing away." And the urgency of Jesus' message is clear. This is the time of fulfillment. Do we feel this urgency in our own lives? Do we feel this urgency today? Do we feel the urgency to proclaim the gospel to others? We live in a country that is in urgent need of God's action. The sanctity of human life is under attack. Under attack through abortion and through the agenda of those who advocate for its unrestricted use. This is unqualified, as the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops just said this again. And it's a clear teaching of the Catechism of the Catholic Church. Sanctity of human life, however, is also under attack from the unwillingness of people to value the sacred nature of marriage and family based on the mutual and life-giving love of husband and wife. The sanctity of human life is under attack through the inability of our leaders to clamp down on the horrors of human trafficking, especially that of children. The sanctity of human life is under attack through the unwillingness to confront the catastrophic damage that pornography inflicts upon individuals, whether they are trapped in the industry or seduced by it online. And the sanctity of human life is under attack from the terrible way people treat those who hold opposing viewpoints and the continued steps to silence them. When it comes to living this life of gospel action, we may not feel qualified, and we may feel intimidated, and we may not even believe that our efforts will have an effect, whether on national policy or on the individuals we encounter and proclaim this message to. But let's go back and look at the gospel. When Jesus calls the first disciples, they left behind their former way of life and followed him. Jesus didn't call the best and the brightest. He called those who were there, those who would carry out his mission. We don't have to be the best and the brightest. We may be, but it doesn't matter. The call is meant to each and every one of us. It is meant for us in the here and now. We all need to repent and leave behind our former way of life. Why? Because each one of us gets caught up in worldly endeavors, in worldly anxieties, in worldly habits. Each one of us at times puts everything else before God, whether it's our work, whether it's our possessions, sometimes even our relationships that make time for God less important. Each one of us is called to be a person of gospel action. It is in light of this reality that we must first recognize our own need to repent and to believe.
was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With the same trust the first apostles had to follow Jesus, let us turn to God and bring him our needs.
For the church throughout the world, may we, through God's grace, continue to grow in the likeness of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation's leaders, may the Holy Spirit inspire them. May the Holy Spirit inspire them in promoting justice for all, especially the marginalized. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those nearing the end of their earthly lives, may Jesus bring them comfort, peace, and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this gathered family of faith, may God bless us and protect us in this new year. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For priests, deacons, and consecrated religious, may they persevere in proclaiming the gospel of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married couples and those preparing for holy matrimony, may they commit in their commitment be to follow behind Jesus in every decision they make. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may our merciful Savior welcome them to paradise. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of Edward J. Brockner, Sr., for whom we pray in a special way in this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now pause and call to mind our own personal intentions. For these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray in a special way for the graces that we need to have our lives be conformed to Christ, to repent, and to live out that gospel message of the truth of God's kingdom. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of mercy and love, we turn to you with trust in your infinite goodness. We ask that you hear the prayers we bring you in the name of Jesus, your Son. Amen.
Amen.
Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation, through Christ our Lord. Through him the hosts of angels adores your majesty, and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise, as we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory."
Jesus Christ.
Lord, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
hours of